Hi everyone. Today we'll do a continuation of the previous video, that is about bubble point and dew point temperature calculations using Raoult's law and Andoin's equations. So if you have not seen the previous video, I have attached the link in the description box and you can go through it. So beginning now, we'll start with the Andoin's equation. So earlier in the previous video, I had spoken about the solving of this problem with the help of Excel solver. This time we are going to solve the same problem using the MATLAB. So first let's go through the question. The question was, find the bubble point and dew point temperatures of 0.5 benzene and 0.5 toluene using Raoult's law and Andoin's equations. And the Andoin's constants are given for both benzene and toluene. Here, please mind it that I am not teaching you the syntaxes or the codes. I'm just simply showing you the method of how you can solve it using MATLAB, how you are going to go about the solution process. And I am using certain syntaxes and commands here. If you want, you can go through other syntaxes that you may have learned during your MATLAB course, or if you have come across any such commands in MathWorks, you can go through that and proceed on with it. So before we begin this solution, first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to make a function file for the Andoin's equation. That is, for the Andoin's equation, whatever values I will be calling into my main function, I am using the a separate function for the initialization when I'll be calling it. So the values which are required to run this Andoin is a, b, c, and t. A, b, c are the constant values. And please remember one thing: the name of your function should also be the name of your file name. The file name is too small. I'm just clarifying that the name that I have assigned to this function is the name by which I have saved these this function file. And log t is one value in total. It's not like from here I can directly get the value of p. From this function I can retain the value of log p only. So I have initialized this function as log p equals to Andoin a, b, c, t. T is the temperature value, and the formula goes like this, and it's n. So I have also written a command line that log p is a single variable. When calling in main script, I have to put it in the exponent form. Now I'll go to the main script and start. So in the very beginning, I have written the CLC and clear all because I want to clear my screen and clear my workspace both, so that no variables or values are stored from the previous from any previous program that I have performed using MATLAB. Now I have already noted down the values of A, B, C for benzene, and values of A, B, C for toluene are noted as D, E, and F. So first we will do bubble point temperature calculation. Now for bubble point purpose, the first thing that we need to do is here we may, as previously discussed, the sum of y, that is the mole fractions in the gaseous phase, should be equal to 1. I'll put this in the command line as well. Okay, so how do we start? Before we go through this summation and all, first thing that I'm going to say is I'll be using symbolic mathematics over here. So I am initializing sims t as a variable for temperature, and y1 will be calculated first using the Andoin's equation. Now, as I had said, the Andoin's was in single variable form, and I have to use exponential form for the main script. So I can write this as 0.5, that is my x1, because y1, okay, I'll write the formula for the help. y1 equals to x1 into p sat by p total. Okay, that is the total pressure is p total, and p sat is the saturation pressure that will be calculated using the Antoine's equation. So 0.5 is my mole fraction into p sat is being called. So I'll write 10 caret. I'm calling the function Antoine a, b, c and p, since I do not know the values of t. So I've just written that's t by the total pressure 760. Okay, and for this is for benzene. When I do it for toluene, I'm just going to copy paste it, and I'll just change the notation to y2. X2 is already 0.5, and here I'll change it to d, e, and f. So now that it's done, I can say that the summation of y1 and y2 should be equals to 1. So what I'll do is I will initialize one equation, which is y1 plus y2 equals to 1. Now I have used a single equal sign over here, and I have used double equal sign over here. What do these things signify? When I am using a single equal sign, it means this equation 1 has a value of this, of y1 plus y2 equals to 1. Now this equals to sign, since this entire thing is one equation, so this equals to signifies that the value of equation 1 is this equation, y1 plus y2 equals to 1 itself, and 1 is the equivalent of y1 plus y2 inside the equation. So this is the difference. Now I will suppress this value so it doesn't print itself in the screen. Then for bubble point, what I'll do is I'll use the solver. Solve equation 1 on basis of which variable should I solve it? Basis of p, because that should give me my bubble point. So let's just run this and see whether it's working or not. So I'll just add it to my path. Okay, so there was some error. Let's see what error I have made. Okay, I have missed out on the brackets. So always be very careful while putting in the brackets. If you miss out on the brackets, this kind of error will come. Never make a mistake while placing the parenthesis, the one which I have made. Let's see whether it runs now. So it's initializing. And yes, we have generated the result. I'll show you the bubble point is equals to 92.012. This is in degree centigrade. Now when we do this for our dew point temperature, when we want to do our dew point temperature, we know sum of x should be equals to 1. Sum of x should be equals to 1. Now since t is already initialized, so I'm not writing it down, I'm just writing down the formula for ease. So x1 is to be calculated, which is equal to y1 into total pressure p total by p sat, or the saturation pressure that will be calculated with the help of Antoine's equation. So let us first write for benzene. X1 equals to 0.5, since we are using the same composition. So now y1 becomes 0.5 into the total pressure, that is 760, divided by this expression. I'm just copy pasting it. So here we go. This is my x1 value, and x2, that is for toluene, it will also be 0.5 into 760 divided by this expression for d, e, f and p. So it's done. Okay, now again we will initialize another equation with a different name, say equation 2, that is equals to x1 plus y1 equals to 1. The same logic for double equal sign and equal sign goes on over here. I'm suppressing this value so that it doesn't print itself. And what I want is dew point equals to solve for equation 2 on the basis of variable t. So this is what I want. Now let me run the entire program. It will give me values of both the bubble point and the dew point. So let's run it. It's initializing. Okay, so first it has shown me that the bubble point is 92.012 and here it has shown me the dew point is 98.7644. So I have obtained the values using MATLAB for the question that we had taken up. In the previous video, I had solved this using Excel solver. Although I had done that in the Google spreadsheet, you can do it in your normal spreadsheet as well. If you are using a very backdated version of Excel, then you can do it with the help of what if analysis. The logic remains the same. And I have used, in case of MATLAB, the symbolic mathematics. You can also do it in some other way where you do not use symbolic mathematics, and you can go about it directly using other inbuilt functions of MATLAB. So that is it. Thank you.